really into working out. He's like, Ron, your body's the temple of God. You gotta keep that thing in order. I'm like,
I'm a mega church. Praise God. Yeah, education building.
For me, getting married was kind of like, it felt like I used to run my own business, and then I got bought out. So now I'm under new management. My salary's been cut in half. And my workload has doubled. It's funny though, because when I was getting married, I would ask married people about marriage. So vague. Nothing specific. Hey, I'm going to be getting married. I want to propose to this girl. What should I prepare for? What should I look forward to? Like, you should just get married. I know, but what should I prepare for? Is it, you know, the good stuff? What is it? Just get married. It's like you walk out to the pool and your buddy's in the pool and you're like, hey, how's the water? Is it cold? He's like, just jump in. Like, is it shallow or deep? Just jump in, man. So you jump in and you're like, whoa, it's so cold. And he's like, yeah, you get used to it. Make a register for gifts where you tell all your friends, buy me something from here or don't come to my wedding. So we registered at a place called, I don't know if you've heard it, Bed Bath & Beyond. You guys have that Bed Bath & Beyond? They put the Beyond there to trick us guys, because I was like, Beyond? Yes! Spaceships and lasers and stuff? Yeah, I'm there. We're going to go in and you go to the Bed & Bath area, I will be in the Beyond area. You go in though, it's just Bed & Bath stuff that's beyond your income level. I'm half Korean and half Irish.
Where are my people at tonight?
Okay, we will hook up later then. How's that? No, it was different growing up Korean and Irish. They would tell us stories like, at the end of every rainbow was a pot of kimchi. Yeah, my mom's a little bit wacky. I remember growing up, she used to compare me to other kids all the time. She always picked this one guy I really didn't like. She was always like, how come you can't be like Billy Lee? He gets his straight A's. He's captain of the math team. He's full Korean. Oh, wait, I forget. My son, he's very good at Nintendo, yeah. Super Mario Master. I bet you get a lot of job with that, huh? Put on your resume, I can save a princess. I remember one day, though, Billy Lee got arrested for selling drugs at school. Oh, praise God. Oh, no, don't take that out of context. I ran home, I'm like, hey, Billy Lee got arrested for selling drugs at school. Without missing a beat, my mom's like, he has a job, too? I don't know if you guys ever snuck into your house, your parents' house when you were younger, but I did. And to get to my room, I have to actually walk by my parents' room, and the floorboards would creak. But if you caught on a good night, my dad was sleeping on his back, he'd snore. So if you timed it right, like you were Indiana Jones or something, maybe you could make it. Sometimes you'd like roll over and just stop snoring, so you're like, uh-oh. Are you there the whole night? My mom comes out, what are you doing? I was doing yoga. I can tell this is really weird though with the family reunions. Because the Irish side would be drinking all the liquor, the Korean side would be selling it to them. It's like, Uncle Bob, you want the paper or plastic? Find a lottery ticket? Okay. It's good luck. I guess there's a little bit of trouble at the wedding, though, because at the end of the wedding, the Irish side start throwing rice. I Freaks kind of got mad. They start throwing baked potatoes. How do you like that? Oh, you want sour cream? No, but after a party like that, people kind of drink up, get a little bit crazy. You have a very big decision to make that night. Are you going to drive home with a drunk Irish guy? Or a sober Korean? Taxi!